in Syria. It was the first time Russian-led forces engaged U.S. troops in 50 years. But again, it was deniable. So we went to the war zone to follow the trail of the Russian mercenaries.
General Jonathan Braga, a veteran Special Forces commander, took us along on his chopper to see, for the very first time, the spot where it all happened, the Conoco oil refinery in eastern Syria. Several of the buildings here took direct hits, but the oil facilities stand, for the most part, undamaged.
I have combat power.
Braga walked us through what happened here on February 7th, starting with the first sign of trouble.
We saw vehicle movements, troop movements, rehearsals and the like. Again, something we hadn't seen before.
So what did you do when you saw this force gathering?
Yeah, I called my contact.
This is like a red phone to the Russians?
Yes, we deconflict with the Russians to make sure there's no miscalculations and de-escalate anything that might be happening.
The Russians assured Braga that they had no forces in the area, and yet the mysterious enemy fighters kept moving forward.
About 2 hours later, we started receiving artillery rounds, followed by tank direct fire, and then eventually small arms fire as well, upwards of several hundred forces.
You were being deliberately targeted, and they were moving artillery in closer and closer.
Absolutely. And that led to, obviously, immediate, again, phone conversation with the Russians.
So you called and said, stop this?
Yes, I did.
But the fire kept coming in. Braga had enough.
We feel threatened. We have certain measures that we take, and we escalate.
And they escalated all right. Within minutes, American airstrikes were coming in, hard. They kept coming for 3 hours. These recordings, authenticated by a senior U.S. military official, are of mercenaries. Russian-speaking mercenaries reporting heavy losses. We had our butts kicked. One squadron lost 200 people. The Yankees, they said, knew we were coming, and they knew we were Russian.
There have been reports that 200 to 300 of the Russian force was killed. Is that accurate?
Yeah, that's, I would say, close to our estimates as well.
That was the first time any American official openly said that. The Pentagon and the White House had been very reluctant to talk about the incident.
I think they wanted to keep this quiet because they didn't want this to escalate into some sort of incident.
Michael Carpenter worked the Russia beat at the Pentagon during the Obama administration. The Russians, he said, were also eager to keep the incident under wraps.
The U.S. side notified the Russian side through our 24/7 deconfliction channel that we were taking incoming and that we were going to call in airstrikes. And the Russians said, copy, we understand that that's going to happen. And yet, the Russian deconfliction center did not notify the mercenaries on the ground that the U.S. Air Force was coming in.
It's the same with after all, mercenaries are deniable and dispensable.
There's nothing necessarily wrong with using contract soldiers, unless, of course, you're lying to your own people and trying to cover up the true nature of a country's involvement in a military adventure in a third country.